achieve it. Today, we are going to talk to a self-made man who made his dreams come true. He is an All India top ranker, civil servant, author, a very versatile person. He is none other than Mr. Burra Venkatesham, a senior IAS officer, secretary for Government of Telangana, youth advancement, tourism and culture, and BC welfare. Sir, we are very proud to have you here. Your profile has a wide spectrum of experience, and I'm really thrilled to have an interview with you.
Oh, thank you very much. It's very nice to be talking to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. As kids, everyone dream. Everyone will have dreams. And you dreamt of being an IAS officer. And you made it true. You made it happen. At what age did you fix your goal of becoming an IAS officer?
Yeah, it was I come from a very small village near Jangaon. So lots of people till they graduate or till they get postgraduate, not many will be knowing what is IAS, how to go about, nothing will be known. But luckily for me, in my school days itself, one of my teachers, one headmaster called Moisinuddin, he was an youngster, he came to our school those days, and then he was telling in a casual talk that the best job one can get through competitive exams is Indian Administrative Service Officer. So I was in that small village, I was always topper in all exams. That was way back in 1979, I was in 6th standard. So then it struck to me, if that is the best job, let me have that only, why anything else? So it's 1979, it went into my head and then it continued like that. So then I went to a residential school called Sarvel. Sarvel Residential School is like Thadikonda in Guntur district and Kodainal in Rayalaseema districts. These three schools were selected, established by our Honorable Chief Minister then, P.V. Narasimha Rao. So he set up the schools for the rural meritorious. So I got selected since I was topper in the entire district, the Warangal district in 7th. So I got selected to these schools. And then when I was reading there also, I was studying there also, when you write your scrapbook books, what is your future? And even those days also I wrote only IAS. One or two other guys also wrote, but they wrote IAS, doctor, engineer. Like it's among many, they wrote one or two guys. So rest, they never knew what is IAS like. So it got imprinted in my mind, so I didn't go anywhere else. It was a straight path towards IAS, so I could achieve it.
Wow, that's not at all easy. Yeah. Coming to your family background, you lost your father at a very young age,
yes,
and your mother was the sole bread and butter winner for your family, yeah, and you're the first person to receive education in your family, and with such tough situations and many challenges, I saw like you didn't even had funds to support your college education.
Yeah.
With all these tough times, how did you become, like how were you able to achieve All India top 15th ranker and Andhra Pradesh first place?
Yeah. See, as I told, my road was very clear. It was like one straight path. But many of the people who were a little more endowed than me, who had more friends or parents guiding them, so their goal was not fixed. So they were like wavering, like, oh, they will go one day this, the other day this side, other day that side. So they were not clear. So their journey will be difficult than our journey, because though you have one problem, only one problem is funds, but clarity of mind is very clear. Those who have funds, their mind is not clear, so they have to go round then round. So any day they will come later than the person who is going in the straight line. So I had one problem, they had many problems in a way. So that's how I see even now. I see the challenge like that. See, the poorer lot or the not so well endowed people have lesser attractions outside, because you can't afford or you are not exposed to it. Today, a rich kid in urban area, he had to come out of many attractions to focus on one goal. Whereas your goal is clear, though funds may be a problem, that is the only problem. Other attractions are not there. So it's comparatively easy. So let's not think that all the rich kids are there, that it's very easy for them to get into a goal. Because their mind is polluted, there are too many attractions. At that young age, when you suppose today's kids, they have so many attractions like a car, club, pub, internet, mobile game, video games. So it's not, in that age, it's very easy to get to them. Coming out of it is very difficult. Suppose you don't have a mobile phone today, I'll tell you it's the biggest advantage. You can concentrate anything.
Very true.
So that kind of situation. I had problem of funds, but rest are all easy for me. So in my civil preparation days, that was in 1989. So 89, before degree results came, I did only BA. I knew I wanted to go to civil service. So my classmates, I was topper in 10th also. I was one of the state toppers. But I knew that I don't have funds. So I don't want to go through engineering and then come back here. So it's a wastage of 1 year. Then for engineering to continue, you have to spend money. So I wanted to go as less as possible in expenses. So I went to BA. I was giving home tuitions, earning little money for my, and then pursuing it. So that year, in the final year of BA itself, I wrote civil service exam. Before my degree results came, I cleared prelims exam. So this normally very rarely happens, because many people will start writing after they become postgraduates. But whereas I was writing the civil service exam alongside of the college degree exams.
Yeah, usually people write after they complete PG.
Yes, I knew I was supposed to go there, because if they were allowing me to write even with intermediate, I would have written. Competing with all the postgraduates. I was so clear.
Wow.
Mind is clear. When mind is clear, rest will happen on its own. Because we, in our Vedic ideology, we have this Yad Bhavam Tad Bhavati. Whatever you see in your mind, you will hold it in your hand one day.
So clarity in thought is very, very
so
important.
So I was seeing it in my mind, what I will do. Sometimes I used to write during preparation itself, Burra Venkatesham, IAS. I used to write.
Wow.
Those days. Okay, I used to tear it off, because you should not do outside, but to give you confidence how it will look like.
Wow.
So today it has become a possibility, you'll see everywhere. So that's what it is.
Very nice, sir.
Yeah.
Clarity in thought and writing your dreams on paper,
yeah,
and it's somewhere, it happens.
Yeah.
And on your journey to become an IAS officer, I know you got many prestigious opportunities. Like you got in railways, RAW, central excise, many opportunities.
Yeah.
How could you resist without taking them? And how could you wait until you met your dream goal?
Yeah. As I told you, my goal is to get into this thing. But why I wrote all these exams is just to prove that, yes, you're on track.
Wow.
See, sometimes what some people do is they only write this exam and they don't do anything else. So all sudden and this exam has the competence levels testing, but at the same time it has also the chance also there. Because about 10 lakh, about 1 million people write. Out of that, top 50 in the country will get into IAS. So 1 million to 50 is a very big challenge. So you may be very intelligent, but there may be a possibility somewhere that you are not selected. So then what will happen? So to give you that confidence, yes, I'm doing good. So write whatever exams are there. And they are like small things for me. So for example, I'll tell you, I was writing for these exams. One day somebody said, why don't you write law set? So law set was... But that time, all the universities in Andhra Pradesh used to take that exam, like MCET for the engineering type. So, without any preparation, I just walked in, and I was AP second, with not even a half an hour preparation. So, like that, because it was only trying to tell you that you are on right track, you are going in the right direction. Suppose you are writing small exams, you are failing. you are not unable to prove yourself, then the pressure will be more on you, or the chance to correct will be there. So since whatever exam I was writing, I was getting, so it was giving me confidence. And I knew I was not going to join, but once you join, then you will become complacent. Once you become complacent, that's why people say you should be little hungry all the time, you should starve for some time. To tell you in Telugu, exactly kadupu kalinappude kashtapanchi panchestaru. Kadupu nindithe nidrapothu. So that starvation, half hungry, is the characteristic of achievers. So whatever you get in till the top, you should not completely fill your stomach or fill your all your comforts. Then that is end of your journey.